Greetings. If you are Muslim, I encourage you to watch this whole video to gain understanding. Thank you, Brother Ari, for your challenge. Your God was born after Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. How can they know about Jesus? Don't be stupid. Did Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob have ever mentioned Jesus as God? What about Moses? Did he ever mention Jesus as God? Think of it. Jesus is not God. Let's examine your claim and see what the real truth is. Your statement includes so many points of confusion, brother. Your God was born. First, brother, being born means entering the world in flesh. So your first misunderstanding, brother, is about entering the world in flesh. In truth, brother, God did enter the world in flesh as the prophets foretold. So where do we get the idea the prophets foretold God would enter the world in the flesh? Isaiah 40 verse 3, the voice of him that cries in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, meaning Yahweh, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Prophet Isaiah revealed another prophet would be a voice announcing the coming of God. God sent this message to foretell John the Baptist, who Islam calls Yahya. Remember, brother, Islam claims to respect the prophets of God. Prophet Malachi confirmed that God would send a messenger or prophet to prepare God's way. Malachi 3:1, behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. And Prophet Malachi confirmed that God would come to his temple. And the Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come to his temple. Right here is probably the only verse needed to prove God would come in the flesh, brother. But let's go through the first point in a little more detail, brother. Malachi 3:1, behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. Please think, brother, about what these words mean. Behold, I. This is God speaking, brother. God's message through Prophet Malachi. Behold, I will send my messenger. God is saying he will send a messenger, meaning a prophet, and he shall prepare the way before me. And that prophet will come before God, preparing the way for God. That means God is coming, brother. And the Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come to his temple. After the preparer has prepared, God will suddenly come to his temple. Remember, brother, Islam claims to respect the prophets of God. Prophet John confirmed that he was the prophet spoken of by Isaiah. John 1:22. So they said to him, who are you? We need an answer for those who sent us. What do you say about yourself? John replied in the words of Isaiah the prophet, I am a voice of one calling in the wilderness. Make straight the way for the Lord. Now where could John have gotten this idea from? It is tempting to think this was only divine revelation to John himself. But it was actually revealed by an angel to the father of John. Luke 1:5, in the time of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah, who belonged to the priestly division of Abijah, and whose wife Elizabeth was a daughter of Aaron. To keep this video short, I will skip intermediate verses that do not change the point. Luke 1:8. One day while Zechariah's division was on duty and he was serving as priest before God. Verse 11. Just then an angel of the Lord appeared to Zechariah, standing at the right side of the altar of the incense. Verse 13. The angel said to him, do not be afraid, Zechariah, because your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you shall give him the name John. Verse 17, and he will go on before the Lord in the spirit and power of Elijah, to turn the hearts of the fathers to their children, and the disobedient to the wisdom of the righteous, to make ready a people prepared for the Lord. Verse 19, I am Gabriel, replied the angel. I stand in the presence of God, and I have been sent to speak to you and to bring you this good news. And now you will be silent and unable to speak until the day this comes to pass, because you did not believe my words, which will be fulfilled at their proper time. Now notice this critical detail. Zechariah would be unable to speak. So Zechariah would be mute for 9 months. It does not say he would be deaf. 6 months later, Gabriel appears to Mary. Verse 26, in the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to a town in Galilee called Nazareth. More time passes, and Zechariah is still not speaking. Verse 57, when the time came for Elizabeth to have her child, she gave birth to a son. Her neighbors and relatives heard that the Lord had shown her great mercy, and they rejoiced with her. On the eighth day, when they came to circumcise the child, they were going to name him after his father Zechariah. But his mother replied, no, he shall be called John. They said to her, there is no one among your relatives who bears this name. Apparently, choosing a family honorific name was something they valued. And I have to interject a personal observation here that people are precious. The family name is such a concern, they cannot just accept her answer. So they have to turn to the father. So they made signs to his father to inquire what he wanted to name the child. They made signs. You make signs to someone you think is deaf. People are precious. Zechariah asked for a table and wrote, his name is John, and they were all astonished. He could not speak yet, but he asked for a tablet. Right now, a squirrel with a lazy mind thinks that is a contradiction. The obvious answer is hand signs and pantomimes of writing, just like they made signs to him. Immediately, Zechariah's mouth was opened and his tongue was released, and he began to speak, praising God. So here, finally, Zechariah could now speak. And he had some things to say after 9 months. Verse 67, then his father Zechariah was filled with the Holy Spirit and prophesied. Verse 76, and you, child, will be called a prophet of the Most High, for you will go on before the Lord to prepare his ways. So Jibril, said John was to prepare the way for God. And Zechariah, after 9 months of silence, repeats John would prepare the way for God. I have no doubt that John had heard these prophecies over him and the miracles around his birth. John was the voice foretold by two other prophets. John was identified as the voice by Angel Gabriel. Why is it so important to really focus on John the Baptist? Because he was the last prophet before the Son of God. John was the one announcing God in the earth. John himself fulfilled several prophecies. Mark 9:11, then they began to question him. This is talking to Jesus. Why do the scribes say that Elijah must come first? Matthew 17:10, and his disciples asked him, why then do the scribes say that Elijah must come first? Now the preceding context of this is another area to study, just not in this video. And his disciples asked him, why then do the scribes say that Elijah must come first? And that idea comes from Prophet Malachi. Malachi 4:5, "Behold, I am going to send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and terrible day of the Lord." But the Pharisees asked John if he was Elijah. John 1:21, "Who are you then?" they inquired. "Are you Elijah?" He said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." As President Clinton would parse, "It depends on what the definition of are is." First, Angel Gabriel already gave this answer. Luke 1:17, "And he will go on before the Lord in the spirit and power of Elijah." Second, Jesus confirms and gives us the same answer as Gabriel. Matthew 11:13, "For all the prophets and the law prophesied until John, and if you are willing to accept it, he is the Elijah who was to come." If you are willing to accept it, that is an interesting way to introduce the idea. And if you are willing to accept it, he is the Elijah who was to come. And in the context of the original question, and his disciples asked him, "Why then do the scribes say that Elijah must come first?" Jesus replied, "Elijah does indeed come, and he will restore all things. But I tell you that Elijah has already come, and they did not recognize him, but have done to him whatever they wished. In the same way, the Son of Man will suffer at their hands." So in verse 12, Elijah has already come, and they did not recognize him, but have done to him whatever they wished. In the same way, the Son of Man will suffer at their hands. They killed John. They will kill me. Then the disciples understood that he, Jesus, was speaking to them about John the Baptist. So John was the fulfillment of Elijah coming before Messiah. Now, Jesus also makes an interesting comment about John, Elijah. Mark 9:13, "But I say to you that also Elijah has come, and they did to him whatever they desired, as it has been written of him." I cannot find Old Testament mention of what they would do to Elijah. Please post if you think you have a verse that this refers back to. Jesus also compliments John the Baptist. Luke 7:28, "I tell you, among those born of women, none is greater than John. Yet the one who is least in the kingdom of God is greater than he." But even complimenting John, Jesus reveals part of the mystery of salvation and those saved. "Yet the one who is least in the kingdom of God is greater than he," greater than John. This implies John was not yet in the kingdom of God. And Jesus had to address issues related to your basic question, brother. "Your God was born after Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. How can they know about Jesus?" Don't be stupid. I have not yet answered your question, brother. First, I needed to lay the foundation of the prophets. Prophet Isaiah, Prophet Malachi, Prophet John, Angel Gabriel, and priest Zechariah. God was coming to the earth in the flesh, and said so before he did. God was coming to redeem mankind from sins. This is the true gospel, brother, the Injil of Jesus, the Lamb of God. I'll get to your question in the next part of my answer to you, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.